Hi everybody, it's your girl Bunny. I hope that you have enjoyed the recap so far. It's Netflix, the original series, Jim Henson's The Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance. Season 1, Episode 7, Time to Make My Move. That's coming up next. It's Bunny. Sandmaster. He has taken them as far as he can take them within the Crystal Desert, and he bids them good journey and at the same time lets them know, follow this stone path which represents the circle, and the circle is a representation of the sun all the way at the top. They look at the large cliff in front of them and wonder, how are we gonna get to the top of this? To put the cherry on the top, after the Sandmaster has left, they see a terrible sandstorm approaching, and they are just thinking it is over. But they still have Law, which is the stone creature, and he gathers them all up, and they all have to hold on tight, and they're fighting the sand, and the stone creature is able to get them all the way to the top, so they are able to reach the destination. Once they get to the top, they see Askesis, and he says, "Welcome!" And they're all very scared, and like, "Oh, it's Askesis!" And he says, "No. I am heretic. I am actually a friendly Skeksis, and you have received my message. I even sent Lore to you to convey the message, so welcome." They're looking at him like, we don't know if we can trust him, but he seems very goofy and playful, and he has all these different jewels and cloths on him, so he seems very different from the Skeksis that they've seen back home. So they believe him and don't think it makes any sense to turn around after this very long journey. So they enter into the room, and he says, "Welcome to the Circle of the Sand." He then introduces them to a mystic named Ergo,
and he talks very slow.
And it frustrates everybody because Princess Breya says, "We have a mission that we have to go on, and you speak very slowly." And Heretic says, "Yes, I know, but this is my friend, but he's gonna get us what we need and the information, and later we have a surprise to share with you that we have been waiting for 376 years to tell you. Oh, and that reminds you, let me go ahead and tell Lore that his journey is complete." And Princess Breya says, "Well, wait, let me say goodbye." So she gives him a hug, and she knows that his journey has ended. We then see that the Emperor has shown the battle general all of these spider creatures that have mutated, and there's this large army of spider creatures, and he tells the battle general, "This is our ally, and in return we offer them their original habitat, which is underground, which was taken from them years ago, and if they agree to help us in this rebellion, we'll make sure that they get their original habitat, because if you remember, we have another clan, which is Deep's clan, that is underground and living underground there, and they've been living there for hundreds of years. So clearly this is something that happened long time ago, and the spider creatures are very interested in taking their original habitat, which is underground where the Groton clan exists, and they agree to help the Skeksis in their rebellion. So Heretic is very excited to show everybody, to show Deed, to show Princess Breya and Rion and Hope the story behind why the Mystiques and the Skeksis exist and how they exist and how they are able to be nice and not the rest of the Skeksis that they've come in contact with. He tells him that Ergo the Wanderer and himself, they had a vision to spread the message of unity bringing everyone together and positive energy. But the other Skeksis didn't agree with that, so they banished Ergo the Wanderer and Heretic. We then see the Emperor. He shows the battle general that he has a way to manifest the darkness that is coming from the crystal and put it into his scepter. He says it's kind of tricky. He's learning how to do it, but his scepter is full of darkness and he has had good luck bringing everything into the scepter. And when needed, he can use his scepter to send out darkness. And the general says, well, what is wrong with your face? And you seem to be different. He pulls back the mask a little bit, the emperor, and he shows him, yes, the good news is that I can pull the darkness and put it into my scepter. The negative side to this is that it's slowly making me decay away. It's slowly deteriorating certain parts of my body. But I don't want to show that to everybody else because then that will be a sign of weakness on my behalf. But I am the emperor. I must show that I am strong and that I have a scepter of darkness. So don't tell anybody about my secret. And the battle general tells him, okay, but I really don't think this is a good idea because we don't need you deteriorating. The hunter has sniffed the path of Deet, Rion, and Hup going to the Circle of Sand. So he knows their path now. So Heretic tells him in his play that originally there were 18 Ersketz that went to the world of Thra. When they arrived to the world of Thra, they saw the crystal, but they knew that Olga was the one that protected the crystal, so they had to think of a way to distract her. So they shared the stories of all of their adventures, seeking the worlds and the universe and all of these different adventures, and that got her interested. So that distracted her from protecting the crystal. Out of their own egotistical ways, they started to do all of these different experiments on the crystal. When they did that, it split the Ersketz into two groups, the Mystics and the Skeksis. Out of anger and so upset that they were split, they ended up breaking off a shard from the crystal, which left it with a deep crack and also created this dark purple of darkness within the crystal. Heretic tells them that they tried to convince the Mystics and the Skeksis to join as one, but they weren't hearing it and they banished them to far, far away. And the only way to have them come to a demise is that they must go to Groton and get the dual sword, which was created and helped to be manifested by the Gelfling. And it holds the power that when it's used, it will cause the Skeksis and the Mystics to fall. So they must journey again back to Groton to get the two-edged sword. Meanwhile, at Stone in the Wood, we have a soldier that comes back to Madra Farah and tells her that we tried to storm the Skeksis, but there were just too many of them. They overpowered us, and it seemed like they were waiting for us because somebody from the inside must have told them we were coming. So if you think about it, Celadon is who gave them the heads up and being prepared and anybody choosing to fight back. So Madra Farah is really sad about that, and she's regretful that she didn't listen to Rion and in the beginning, but now all they can do is move forward and try to make the best of things and continue to spread the word that there's danger among the Skeksis. They're prepared to go on this voyage with all of the different soldiers in Stone in the Wood. We have Olga who arrives and she says, well, no, wait a minute, because in a vision, the Skeksis do see their demise, but it's not by you. So I'm trying to warn you and tell you, do not journey to where the Skeksis are because you all will fail. Don't do it. And Madra Farah is not hearing it. She says, well, if we don't do it, who else is going to do it? We're not going by a guess in your vision. We're going to go ahead and march forward. And Olga tries to tell her, I know it's hard to understand, A song has different melodies, but there's only one ending. And I can tell you, I know the ending. And if you go forward, Stone in the Wood will fall. Before Brea and Rion and Deet and Hup can leave, we have Heretic and we have Ergo. It's a lot of names. Tell them to be safe, to find the double-edged sword, and they wish them well. And before they leave, he gets an arrow to his hand, Heretic, and we see it's the hunter. The hunter has tracked them down and found them, unfortunately. And he says, I came for my trophy. I cannot go back to the Skeksis without my trophy. And he's yelling and everybody else is screaming. And we have, what's his name? I'm sorry. And we have Heretic scream to Brea, you must wake up Lore. You must wake him up, which is the stone creature. Because before, he took away the awakening stone so he fulfilled his journey to put him to sleep. But he's telling Brea, you must wake him up so they can help them fight. When she's trying to do that, we have the archer that shows up, which is the same person that Olga told and said that I had a vision that you have to go to this area to fight the hunter. So he's there, and as the archer is pointing his arrow and shooting the hunter, he is feeling the blows. And because remember, the Skeksis and the Mystics are one, even though they're living separate. So they can feel what each other is experiencing. And the archer is continuously hitting him with arrows, hitting it with arrows, and he is feeling it too. And archer is going closer and closer to the ground. And the hunter says, I'm gonna take my trophy. And he grabs Princess Freya and takes off. And unfortunately, there's nothing that they can do. So the hunter now has Princess Freya. Final scene, we see the general of battle, and he has arrived to Stone in the Wood. And as Madra Farah and all of her soldiers are preparing to go fight the Skeksis, he's arrived and he releases this creature to go to everyone. And as they go to everyone, they attach to the ear and they have a connection with the brain. And all of a sudden, they are comatose. So the general says, basically, you are under my command. And they say, we are under your command. And Olga is a distance away watching all of this happen. Very, very upset that they didn't listen to her and that they didn't hide and that they didn't wait for somebody else to take down the Skeksis. So now they are under a mind control animal. And as they're under mind control, they all follow him as an army back to the castle. So now they have the spider creatures as allies, and they have majority of all of the soldiers to help them fight as well against the Gelfling. Pardon me, I'm trying to remember all of the names and what happened exactly. But Olga, that creature tries to take mind control over her, but it doesn't work. She's too powerful. So one thing that we have to remember is that Heretic told them that you have to unite all of the clans. You have to spread the word as much as you can so you can all go against in rebellion against and have resistance against the Skeksis. If you get all seven clans together, though you are small, you have hope to fight and have a victorious win. So that was the episode. Pardon my little hiccups here and there and trying to remember all of the names and sequencing, but there was a lot. Tell me what you think. Subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my posts. And also follow me on Instagram, same profile name, officialbun_e. We're almost finished. Stay tuned for episode 8. It's all coming up next. See you next time. Bye.